Good morning, family of fast. Matt Mosman, the chief endurance officer over at EndurElite. Today, we're gonna talk about three supplements that can help you hyperhydrate before you go out to train or race. Now, why would you wanna hyperhydrate before a race or a training session? Well, depending on how hot and humid it is, hyperhydration may be a useful strategy to prevent dehydration from happening or delaying dehydration, especially if you're not drinking enough fluid during your training and racing sessions. And then also on the same token too, I know a lot of you don't like to drink a lot of fluids during your races, especially you OCR folks that are climbing over obstacles when, you know, getting some fluids might be few and far between, or you just don't like to carry anything with you in terms of fluid. So in these situations, hyperhydration may be able to prevent dehydration to some extent, or at least delay it. And we all know that a 2 to 3% decrease in bodily weight or fluid during exercise can have some pretty negative consequences on your performance, as far as making you tire out quicker, and in worst case scenarios, heat exhaustion and heat stroke. So we wanna avoid those if at all possible. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna tell you three supplements that you can take, how much and at what time to kind of help hyperhydrate your body before you go out training and racing. Now, the first one is betaine, or trimethylglycine, which is a derivative of the amino acid glycine, and it's naturally found in things like beet. Now, betaine is an osmolite, which basically means it helps protect the cell from dehydration. And in this case, betaine helps with water retention in the cell. Now, to get the full effects of betaine, you want to take anywhere from 2.5 up to 6 grams daily, divided into two doses. Timing really doesn't matter here. So that's the first one, betaine. The second one is glycerol. Now, some of you may have experimented with this before, and the way glycerol works, it basically causes the cell to uptake, or causes the cells to uptake more water into them, so it kind of hyperhydrates the cell. Now, as far as dosing on glycerol, I'm gonna get my book out here because I can't remember this because I'm old. So with glycerol, you need to ingest 1.2 grams per kilogram body weight and 26 milliliters per kilogram body weight of fluid 60 minutes prior to exercise. So timing kind of matters here a little bit. You can also add a little bit of glycerol in your bottles if you're out drinking during training and racing to kind of help prolong the hyperhydration. So far we have betaine and glycerol. Now, the third one is one supplement I'm totally in love with, and all of you know this, and this is creatine monohydrate. Now, creatine kind of works similar to glycerol as far as it promotes water uptake in the cell. Now, with creatine, the dosing is a little bit tricky for endurance athletes. Most of the time, you'll hear 5 grams daily of creatine, and that's fine. That'll lead to some pretty significant uptake of water into the cell and benefits, but you also might experience some weight gain if you take that 5 grams of creatine. So I would start, if you want to try this as a hyperhydration strategy, start by taking anywhere from 2 to 3 grams of creatine daily and see if that affects your weight at all. You know, if not, great. If you don't mind gaining a little bit extra weight, you know, no big deal at all. And then with the timing of creatine really doesn't matter too much. You may take you a while to see the benefits of the hyperhydration with creatine though, as a traditional loading period at 5 grams a day takes up to 28 days, but you'll probably see some benefits of hyperhydration a little bit before that. So that's it. In a nutshell, my endurance friends, the three supplements that can help with hyperhydration are betaine, glycerol, and creatine monohydrate. On another point, don't mess with all these various other forms of creatine. There's a lot out there that'll say, you know, it absorbs or is more soluble and all this other blogna, but stick with the king of creatine monohydrate. It's cheap, it's effective, and it's probably one of the best supplements out there in terms of, well, performance, and then to some extent with the hyperhydration. So that is all I have today for my endurance friends. I'm gonna go head outside right now and sweat my ass off in this hot South Dakota heat. But if you have a friend who's constantly dehydrated or might find some use in some hyperhydration strategies, please share this video with them. If you want other videos like this on endurance training, nutrition, and supplementation, subscribe to the EndurElite YouTube channel or head on over to the EndurElite blog at www.endurelite.com. Get social with us on InstaSlam and our Facebook Training and Nutrition Club page. And until next time, my friends, stay fueled, stay focused, stay fast, and stay informed.